So, hello everyone. So, my name is Meindert. I'm going to tell you about a little printer project. At least I thought it was a little printer project that I've done for the HP41CL. So, if you don't have a 41CL, either get one or get some lunch, because this will not be for you. So, I'm not going to go into all the technical details. I want to go more into a story about how I developed it and what hurdles I came across. First of all, I want to thank Hans-Peter and Matthias for setting this up again. So it's really great to see all the calculator friends and the contributors to the community. I really like that, and that's why I'm here. So, again, as I told you, this is more about the journey that I made to get something up and running. So first of all, the inspiration for this project came from the DM41X. So one of the first things when I had this module is to find out ways how to get information in and out of it. And unfortunately, it turned out to be quite limited from the HP view. So one of the things I did is I found out it can print. It has an infrared transmitter. So the first thing I did is one of the first things is to make this one. This is an HP infrared receiver. And Martin Heppeler did a little project with an Arduino built-in, which I copied. I did a few changes. So if you have a device which can print infrared, get one or make one. It's quite simple. If I will pass it around. And it turns out that it will work with a 34S, it will probably work with a 42, I hope with a 43. And it's real nice, and it works with Christoph's printer emulator on a PC. So it's a really good way to get information out of the DM41X. So I thought, well, if this is possible on a DM41X, it is possible in a 41CL. A 41CL has a serial port, it can be controlled. So why not get the printer information out of the serial port into the emulator? So that's why I started developing the Y printer. And it also learned, I learned a lot about the DM41X, which is quite interesting, because I found out that the DM41X uses the standard unmodified printer ROM, which is pretty strange because it only produces a stream of data and control characters. So what's inside, and thanks to Rob Prosperi and the Swiss Micro team behind it, I have some insight into what's happening. So there is a translation to the infrared printer codes, because these are really totally different ways of printing. And there is a way to read the status flags 15 and 16, because this is to control the normal manual and standard printer modes. So there is some interaction between the closed HP41X or DM41X side plus the firmware. And then it goes to the little box, which has an amplifier and filter and the Arduino code, and then goes into Christoph's emulator through a USB emulated serial port. So it's quite logical, but there's quite a lot of magic happening. So what I wanted to do is to make this printer for the 41CL to be used with a PC, a printer emulator, and maybe even a real printer, to use the serial port, and to integrate it in the 41CL ecosystem. So one of the first things I did was to contact Monty and to reserve his name. Even before I did some tests, but I did it quite early before someone else would catch his name. So that's why it's called Y Printer. So the challenges are how to use these flags to control the printing modes. Can we support graphics? Can it work with the emulator? And how do flags 21 and 55 work? Because there's only one-way traffic. You can only get data out. You cannot get information from the printer. So that were the challenges. So first of all, thanks to Doug Weiler, he made a printer study, which was extremely helpful. I don't think I could have done it without it. There is improved FASM listings for the printer. I made some own disassembly listings. And there is some insights in how the printer works in the HeapX manual, but there are some mistakes in that. So be careful when you do that. So what I found, first of all, there is an instruction to control the printer. There are 6 commands, and very good, there are some knobs in the printer room. So I thought, well, maybe I can use that to control the serial port. And something else is that the instruction set of the NUT has really printer instructions, but they're never used. So these are the actual printer commands. I won't go through them in detail, but there are 6 different, or 6 different commands that the printer uses. So somehow I had the thought of replacing these with a execute to a routine that does something with the serial port or emulates. So that was really the first thought. And I did an analysis of the printer ROM to find out where these instructions are used. So I found that the power on is used 9 times, the valid instruction used only 2 times, this is used only once, and the busy is used 2 times, and the printc, which is really the instruction to print something, is used only once. So there are 2 routines to be patched. One is to get the status, which is the FNSTS, and the other one is the routine really to put print information out, which is in the P byte C routine. And the power on, I thought, well, the DM41X must do the same. It simply ignores these instructions. So I replaced the instructions for a power on check just to assume printer is on. So if you plug this ROM, the printer is always on, and that influences the flags 55 and 21. So simply skip it. That was the easy part. The other thing is a valid test. There is something in the printer. If you read the status is not always valid. So this instruction checks if the status is valid, and if it's not valid, then you have to check the status again. Now, I'm not really interested in the printer status, if it is busy or not. So I thought, okay, let's skip this step. And because I always have a valid status, that was my assumption. So also remove this test. And to check if the printer is busy, I don't care so much. The only thing I care about is the serial port, if the serial port is busy. And I can do that check in the real printing routine. So also this check can be skipped. This is an instruction to read the flags, to read the printer status. And basically the only thing that I'm interested in here is the status of flags 15 and 16 to control the printer mode. And this is something which is not in the normal printer or in the fixed printer, but it is in the HP IL printer. So you control these modes. And the printc instruction, really to send information to the printer, obviously that is something that must be replaced by an instruction for the serial port. So this limits the scope of what has to be changed. And furthermore, I discovered that the printer name has no return, so you cannot use it as a function. So if you would, by mistake, use it as a function, you end up nowhere with a big crash probably. So I think that's probably a good fix for the printer ROM as well. So next step is to, what is the status bits that you get? Well, there is all these bits. And I thought, well, the only thing I'm interested in is the slider for the printer mode. And replace this with some code to read the user flags. The rest, paper advance, out of paper, it's one-way traffic only. So there's nothing I can do there. And some of the other things, lowercase, double white mode. I thought, okay, let's forget it for a while. Ignore it. So the only thing is I did is to return a correct status and read user flags 15 and 16. So what is difficult here? One is that a printer is fixed in page 6. And the operating system uses a lot of entries in the printer ROM that you simply cannot touch. But the fixed page has the advantage that you can use the short instructions for subroutines. And the subroutines that I needed to patch are pretty cleverly programmed with a lot of jumps and also calls from other places. And even with the documentation available, it's not always clear which registers are used and how many subroutines levels are used. And of course, there are the interrupt entries that are used. The other problem here is how to develop the ROM. Normally, what I would do is to use Calypsy, which I find a great tool to write microcode. It has everything that you want to do. But the printer ROM is a fixed ROM, and I would have to extract the source and make sure that if I would recompile it, I would get a result that is exactly the printer. So no changes. So I decided to use the David assembler and to edit in place because I don't want to disturb the rest of the printer ROM. And of course, to make regular backups of the code, because I did have a lot of crashes. Then the next step is how to document, how to really write the code, because that's important. And I used Excel, which is a great tool, because it turned out that I have to had very good tracking of the contents of the registers. And you will find out later why. So, how to do it? What I did is first make a copy of the printer ROM in QRAM, plug that in page 6, and then have another QRAM page in page 7 to jump there. So I had a lot of space to do some code. That is one thing. Then there's the problem of testing. Easiest way is to use V41 for this type of testing. But I depend on specific hardware here, which is the 41CL and the serial port. So for me, that was not an option. There are not really much debugging tools that can be used specifically for this ROM. There are some tools to do MCode debugging, but not suitable for a printer ROM. So the final result is that I had a lot of crashes to remove the battery. And probably one of my next little projects have a real reset button on the 41CL to get out of that. So this is the documentation. I will skip all the details. This is what you get from the FASM listings of the printer. So to get the status is actually three different routines. And these routines, they have a lot of jumps in between. And there is some code that needed to be preserved because it's used by other code. So this was quite tricky. But finally, there is about this area that could be used for alternative code. The next one is really the workhorse to get something to the serial port, which is the P byte C, which is actually much simpler code. And what it does is have a little timeout loop to check if the printer is busy. That was a loop to check if the serial port is busy, and then actually send something to the serial port. So that's quite easy. So basically, and this is how to send, this is what I have to do to send data to the serial port of the 41CL. And to my surprise, no one else has done something similar to basically write Ncode to do something to the serial port. I think with the updater is a good example. And I love your updater, because I wouldn't know what to do without it to get this 41CL up to date. But in a sense, controlling the serial port on the 41CL is relatively simple. So I had a plan. plan A. Simply get rid of all the power on checks, replace all the relevant select peripherals for the printer to a new routine, and basically I only had to do a new print C because that was really different to control the serial port. And there is a range of knobs in the printer room that could be used, and I thought, well, maybe it would fit. And I can use only a single ROM and don't have to use a second page. And I thought the other option, well, if I needed more space, then I could remove the user code, which is in the printer ROM. But then again, I thought, well, maybe that's not a good idea. I want to keep it as original as possible. So let's keep the code there and try to see if I can fit it in what is available. So the results of plan A. Patching the power on checks was quite easy. I could make the status much shorter, simply reading the flag registers and putting the status of flags 15 and 16 in the correct bits. And I thought, well, this may actually work. So the first version, I did a test with print alpha and accumulate alpha, and it worked. So I thought, okay, this is it. But then I tried out some other things like printx, printstack, and I couldn't print a register. And also, in a running program, the alpha view, it didn't work. So I thought, something else is going on. So I had to do a further deep dive, because I found out in the print instruction all the subroutine levels were used. So I couldn't use if no carry execute inside this routine, which is solved quite easily by simply not using executes, but a go sub or a go to and then return. So I thought, well, that was simple, so I had a plan B. Not use subroutines. So the issue was in print byte C, but I also found out that when checking the flag register, it was not what I wanted it to be. And one of the things is that what I did is to make a call to the read the flag register. And that was an extra subroutine level, which I couldn't use. But I mean, this was relatively easy to fix, and the code fitted exactly inside the knob space. And the results was print alpha, accumulate alpha, and actually print program worked. Sort of, but printing a register or printing the display with alpha view still didn't work the way I liked it. So a further deep dive turned out that I needed to preserve almost all registers in print by C. It's not possible to change anything except for one register. I believe it's the end register, which I could use. But that is very inconvenient because I needed some other registers for a timeout loop. So I needed to do something else. And it turned out that printing a register and printing with alpha view actually prints the display. So it doesn't analyze the register and then prints it, but it prints, it reads back the status of the display. And when you select the peripheral of the 41CL, you deselect the display. And if you then go back, then strange thing happens. So that's not good. So I thought, okay, here is a problem. So I needed to fix that to make everything work. So I needed to preserve the registers. This is my plan C. That is one thing. And I had to do something with the display. And I needed to save one or two bytes, so 16 bits of register, just to be able to have the A register for a timeout loop for the serial port. I had no other choice, so I had to do something and have some spare memory just to save 16 bits of space. And fortunately, the 41CL has a lot of memory, but it's not so easy to use it. And there is some intermediate storage space, so I decided to use the space reserved for the updater because we're using the serial port for the printer and the updater uses the serial port, so that's no conflict, I hoped. And the code to access the memory is quite a lot of code. I'm not sure how many of you have actually programmed M code to access 41CL memory, but of course it's not so easy. You need a lot of code, especially if you don't have any registers to spare. Yeah. Yeah. So the next step also was to fix the selection of the display. So I had to return selecting the display, and actually there is the routine in the printer room to print the display. I only had to fix one jump and also fix something inside that jump to keep the display selected. So that was not too complicated. I had to write an alternative enable LCD routine back again, because the standard enable LCD routine in the OS, it throws away register C, which did not work here. So the final result is that it worked, to my surprise. But I had quite a lot of code, and I didn't want to use a second page, so I had to go back and use bank switching, which I had never done before. I've never coded anything with bank switching. Fortunately, the first attempt to do that worked. There were some unexpected issues with the polling entries, which I hadn't really taken care of before. And then I looked at what are the interrupts actually doing. Most of the interrupt entries, they're used to check the keys of the printer. And I don't have a real printer, so I simply disabled everything, except what is necessary for the regular operation. The other challenge was to do something with bank switching and to actually code something in bank switching, which is quite tricky again. But thanks to the 41CL, you can plug a page, a RAM page, in where it's supposed to be, in the second bank of page 6 here, and at the same time in a normally accessible page where you would edit, and then it would edit. It would change the second bank as well. So that's a really nice trick of the 41CL, which I don't think is possible in any of the other platforms. So remember this trick.
Is this by the same address on both pages?
You can plug one page in two different, or one ROM image or QRAM image in two different pages, two different slots. Yeah.
That works unless the whole thing has polling points itself.
The polling points, I also had some issues with it. So when editing that, you have to put all the polling points to zero because these are used especially with the printer. Yeah. Printer is a pretty crazy ROM. It's used all the time by the operating system. So you have to be really careful with that. The other thing with a bank switching ROM is that if you want to do it in the proper way, at the end of the ROM, you have to do a few enable bank instructions. So it gets recognized by the hex editor, so you can change banks. But of course, the standard printer ROM has some code there. And fortunately, it was exactly in the good place to have these enable bank instructions that code could be moved. And these are all short jumps from the polling points. So you have to tweak a bit, and thanks to the fact that I could remove some of the printer power on check, which is there, I had just exactly enough free space to patch these codes. So there's also a bit of luck. I was going to show some code, which I won't do. The next step is, okay, I had something working, so I could send data out of the HP41CL printer port, but it didn't work with Christoph's emulator. So I looked into this part a bit more closely, and it turned out that the printer codes for the 143 printer and the infrared printer are really totally different and also totally incompatible. So I thought, what can I do to actually test it, except from seeing output on the serial port? So fortunately, I had the USB 41 device from Diego, which is almost the same as in the DM41X. It catches the select peripheral instructions, so it's a module with the USB connector, and it is a printer emulator, it's a full printer emulator. So it translates these printer codes to a serial port, and Diego has written an emulator on the PC, which does exactly the 143 printer, but no graphics, only text. So I had a working solution with one emulator, but I must say I like Christoph's emulator better because it also integrates with V41 and with HPIL and with the pillbox, so that's a much more complete environment to use. So then what are my options to get graphics printing? One is to approach Diego to ask to add graphics, but again I liked Christoph's emulator better, so I then had two options left. One is to do the trick as in the DM41X, to translate the printer codes to the infrared printer codes. But this is really, really tricky. So I have some insights in how the DM41X does it. And this is going to be really tricky, but it's very possible. The other option is to just take the infrared printer module, the Blinky for the 41, and use that ROM and patch that for the serial port. The problem there is that there is no documentation. There is one implementation, I believe. I haven't tried it. I looked at the printer, at the Blinky code. It's a banked ROM, two pages, and the printer instructions are totally different, and I have no idea what they do, and these are, as far as I know, totally undocumented.
Very opaque. That one is very opaque.
Yes, yeah. So that is not really an option. So basically, this is where I am now. I looked at Christoph's sources. I communicated with Christoph, so I now have a version of Christoph's emulator that I'm trying to adapt to the 143 printer. And I think ultimately the goal will be to have a version of the emulator with the 143 serial port support, so you can print from the 41CL. This is Diego's printer emulator. So this is my 41CL. One thing which is a bit special, I mean, I'm a hardware guy, so I couldn't let go. The serial to USB adapter is built inside the 41CL, so I have a USB port on my 41CL. It saves me some cables, and it's it works.
What speed do you have? The serial port,
that's one of the nice things of only sending data out, is that you can use almost any serial speed. So it works really good at 9600 baud. So the problem with the 41CL serial port is that the speed is limited when you receive data, because the calculator is not fast enough to keep up with high baud rates. But when you send data, and it really makes a difference when you send data. So I'm setting it to the highest possible baud rate. Then I need to... What settings?
No.
Okay. Well, I'll set it up on the desk with my own PC. I just tested it. It works quite well. So you can use a really high speed serial port, 9600. Works fine. Flex 15 and 16. FLAC 15, you can use trace modes, it prints programs, so it really is a good printer solution. I had a talk with Christoph yesterday about the next plans. V41 has printing capabilities, but you have to use virtual IL. I think with the 41CL, I tend to fill up my 41CL with all kinds of ROM. I do have an HPIL module, but it's always two pages. So this printer is really my preferred solution, but V41 does not have this printer support. So maybe, Christophe, it is a possibility to expand V41 with this, just to have the extra page free. But for some reason, my V41 is never filled up. Only my real calculators are typically filled up with all kinds of stuff. So I typically, the printer is always port 6. There's no way to change this. And then I have OS6 in page 7, which really is a nice solution. And then I can still print using the serial port.
Can you use a different page in 7? Because I'm using HPIL all the time. So
OS X goes into any page, so that's your choice. But this printer emulator has to be in page 6.
Yeah, the printer, that's sure, but your Y function, YT?
No, Y print is really a replacement of the printer. It has to be in page 6.
So that's the page 6, but you're saying that you have two banks.
Yeah, but two banks in page 6.
On the page 6, okay. Yeah. So that's page, why do you need page 7?
Oh, no, I use page 7. HPIL uses page 6 and page 7.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, and page 7 is for HPIL. But typically, I find that I use HPIL only for printing.
Yeah, but if I disable HPIL, it goes to page 4.
Yes.
So if I don't use library 4, because that's another one, I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
Then you can do that, yeah. But in any case, if you then you cannot print. And this is intended for printing. So, yeah. Angel.
So I have one question. The graphics mode is not supported. Is that what is funky?
No, there is no. This emulator does not support graphics. No, no. And there is graphics in the Blinky emulator. But the graphics codes from this printer, so the 143 to the 82 whatever. They're completely different, and they're also really difficult to implement in the ROM. I mean, it's implemented in the DM41X, and it works great there. But again, the way to implement it and the difference between the codes are really big. I would have to buffer all the graphics, and then do a calculation, and then send it. So that would be really complicated, and I think this is actually the easier solution to expand the printer emulator.
I have another suggestion for you to do this project,
yeah. Good.
Which would be matching your talent. Get a way to communicate using two HPCLs using the serial link for program swapping and copying.
Actually, I have. Yeah, I have my own to-do list, is to do exactly that, to send a raw program, for example, easily to a PC or to somewhere else, because those tools do not exist yet. To send a raw program, a user program, or an X-memory file, or whatever, to something else. I have now pretty good control of how the serial port works, which is surprisingly easy. And after that, it's just a matter of writing the code. So I have some ideas for that, to exchange data between the 41CL and something else in a more easy way. But it's on a to-do list with no date or deadline on it, of course, as we all have. Good. No more questions then. Thank you very much.